Alright guys, so we're here, National Museum of the Marine Corps. This is like the mecca of Marines. This is my third time in my Marine Corps career coming here. If you guys can look at this, what does this look like to you? That's right, if you guessed the flag raising on Mount Suribachi on Iwo Jima, you are correct. So let's go in, gents. These devil dogs getting some.
Yards and miss the target.
This nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow.
For us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us.
In the contentious modern world, where industrialized empires clash with each other and local populations for dominance, small expeditionary Marine Corps had their work cut out for them. Merchant colonial power, whose Navy and Marine Corps served as a mobile overseas force in readiness, set to protect the nation's political and commercial interests in an increasingly competitive and dangerous world.
Number of many and the Battle of Waterloo. It was a crisis. In 5 days, the Germans had pushed within 40 miles of Paris.
The assault companies had no radios. Wristwatches were synchronized. From thousands of meters away, the artillery advanced with only barrage and predetermined degrees. To push the wall of covering fire forward, according to a rigorous plan, the commanders determined by the terrain, the enemy defenses, and the stamina of their infantry. Once the bombardment began, teamwork and fighting spirit decided the outcome.
We drew the map of the world. It would be, the victorious Allies vowed, the war to end all wars.
We interrupt this program to take you to the NBC newsroom. Japan has attacked Pearl Harbor from the air and all naval and military activities on the island of Oahu, the principal American base in the Hawaiian Islands. President Roosevelt quickly sprang into action and ordered the Army and Navy to use their full power for the defense of the United States. The Japanese have drawn first blood. The attack was a complete surprise.
We have heard this morning the attack of Pearl Harbor and the air bombing of Pearl Harbor by Army planes, undoubtedly Japanese. The city of Honolulu has also been attacked and critical damage done. The battle has been going on for nearly 3 hours. It's no joke.
Terrible. They came up with an innovative idea of converting their logistic support tracked landing vehicles, LVTs or Amtraks, and use them in the assault waves to get over that reef and carry the troops to the beach. They bolted on cheap scrap iron to the sides of the cabs and put more machine guns.
Propose an alternate, closer, and safer amphibious objective.
The amphibious landing is the most powerful tool we have.
Yes, sir, it is. But any amphibious landing is an operation of many details, interlocking and interdependent, each of which has to be performed successfully or risk jeopardizing.
Working on Private first class, Wayne Scott.
Everything froze. Our carbines wouldn't work. Artillery rounds fell short, sometimes into our own positions. Morphine froze hard as stone.
That third platoon that's getting hit up there now, isn't it, Sergeant? Is it true help ain't coming?
Steady yourself, Morphine.
Aye. The scuttlebutt is that the enemy owns the whole road.
Vision knows we're here, they're trying. But everybody, everywhere from UDOT and E down to Coulter is being hit just as hard. Skipper's been hit.
Captain Parker, how bad?
He's hit, but he never quits. He's on his feet, completely calm, walking the line. He can hold it, we all can too. Now listen up. Ammo's tight, real tight.
I got a clip and a half. But I can't feel my feet anymore.
Changing from a boat to a rifle.
The Grumman F9F2 Panther was an attack pilot's dream.